want to buy a duck, you can go to the Second Harvest Food website for more information on that. And Margaret, hopefully the weather will be fantastic for it. I know you'll be out there tomorrow.
I'm going to be out there along with Dev and Lucy. But wait, I want you to know 30,000 ducks are going to be raised. I know, right? And each duck costs $5. Each duck can provide 20 meals. $5 provides 20 meals. And Second Harvest is saying that they're seeing more and more people in need, as many as 20,000 additional people, mostly because of inflation. So if you can help out, there's still a few ducks remaining, and just come on out and support Second Harvest Food Bank, because it's going to be a lot of fun. I hope I see you there. So looking outside, it's pretty nice right now. The rain is diminishing. Let me show you the forecast. Going to all of the games, so many things happening this weekend. So for Tulane, they're playing Alcorn State, 3 o'clock. You've got a 40% chance of rain. Temperatures in the mid-80s. Now, I'm going to show you the forecast model in a second. I am seeing rain in the evening, about 6 to possibly 7 o'clock, so you're going to have to be aware of that. And then a huge game, LSU versus the Southern Jaguars. It's at Tigers Stadium. So we're going to be in the mid-80s in the afternoon, some scattered activity. You know, I would wear shoes that don't slip. Keep that in mind, and keep the slicker handy, too. As for the Saints, hey, you're at the Mercedes-Benz Stadium over in Atlanta. Chance of rain in the afternoon during the game. We do have rain chances as well. Do you know what tomorrow is? It is September 10th. It is the most active day in hurricane climatology, and we're going to have Earl, which is expected to become post-tropical tomorrow. And this little system, which is moving off of Africa, still over Africa. So on the most active day, we're not going to have a lot of activity. But I've got to say, Earl is hanging tough. I mean, max winds at this point, 105 miles per hour. It's racing to the northeast at 29 miles per hour. The big problem that it's going to cause for the United States and up into Canada, huge swells, rip currents. So if you have friends who are going to be along the East Coast, they're going to have to be careful. And then here is a look at Kay. It's now post-tropical. It is moving to the west-northwest, but the big problem with Kay is that it's sending rain into the southwest, and they can't handle a whole lot of rain. We've got a cold front to the north. That's the one that's moving through late Monday for the most part and is going to be giving us some drier air. So we did get some rain this evening, and this is kind of interesting. If you look aloft, you can see how the airflow is splitting, and that's what we call upper-level diffluence, and that helped with the rain. Here we've got some storms down here at Grand Isle, the mouth of the river moving into St. Bernard. No rain at this point in the metro, though we did have a lot of rain over the Wrigley's and the Slidell Twin Span. Rainfall totals, some of us got some locally heavy rain, but at this point it's diminished. Over the bucket, Bogalusa had over an inch of rain. So let's look at the forecast. In the morning, patchy fog, lows upper 60s to the mid 70s. Tomorrow by lunchtime, mid 80s, you've got rain developing. So here we are, 6 o'clock. And over at Yulman Stadium, looks like you've got rain. It lingers until maybe 7 o'clock, then it's moving out. So just at game time, you may have that risk. Then I want to take you into Sunday. Hey, it's looking pretty good. It's going to be hotter, high temperatures in the upper 80s, lower rain chances. So your forecast, we've got that cold front getting into the area Monday with drier air moving in, it looks like, for Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. I like that.